Hey guys, welcome back. I'm glad you could join me today. And I'm going to be doing something actually a little bit different. I've never done this before, and I'm just going to really talk about a box set. Within the past week, went out and purchased the Jam LP box set. And there's a few things I want to talk about before I get to show you the box set. And just kind of show you my progression on what led me to purchase a box set that really honestly I don't know very much about. And you might think, well, you're crazy. You know, why are you buying box sets when you really don't know the music? But there is a story, so stick with me here and I'll kind of explain myself as we go. About, I would say, 6 weeks ago, maybe 2 months ago, I purchased this CD box set, Paul Weller, Hit Parade. And this was right around the time he performed at Glastonbury, I guess it was. Was it Glastonbury? The big UK music festival that just happened at the tail end of the summer. I can't remember what it was. I don't think it was Glastonbury. It was, I forget. You guys know what it is. Anyway, he performed there. Got a lot of critical acclaim, and a lot of people were talking about it, how good his performance was. So I'm like, well, I like Paul Weller, don't I? I'm not really sure. And I went and looked through a lot of my 80s albums and realized I had nothing from the Jam. I had no Paul Weller albums, solo albums, even though I know he recorded his solo stuff mostly in the 90s and up through today. And I had a lot of Style Council, and I've always enjoyed the Style Council. So I'm thinking in my mind, why didn't you ever get into his solo work, or why didn't you ever get into the Jam previous to the Style Council? So it just led to me thinking, okay, I gotta get something from Paul Weller. I gotta know more about this artist. So I went out and I purchased this box set, which is a fantastic compilation. Great place to start. The first two CDs in the box are all Jam material, so you do get a lot of Jam songs. In fact, I think it's about 50. I don't know how many singles they had, but apparently quite a lot. And it's, you know, a great, great introduction to the Jam. And then the final two CDs, you get a CD of all of his work with the Style Council, hits-wise, that is. And then you get a CD of his, maybe it's two CDs. Hang on, I want to give you the right information. You get one CD of the Jam, sorry. One full CD of the Jam. I'll just show it. Maybe if I shut up, it'll just be easier. So you get a CD of the Jam. There's about, what, 20, 22 songs there. You get a CD of the Style Council. Hits and whatnot there below it on disc two, and you get two CDs of his solo work up through whenever this box set came out, I guess around 2010, something like that. So I really enjoyed it. That's what the bottom line is. I really, really think a lot of this box set. I've been enjoying it ever since I bought it. All of it. Style Council, the Jam, and his solo work. So I've been very intrigued by getting more and more and more. Okay, so that purchase and that discovery led me to about a month ago when I did my What is Your Favorite Album of the Year? You know, I ran that little contest, had a great variety of responses, and my friend Ben Simpson said his favorite album of the year so far is the new Paul Weller album, Saturn's Pattern. And I had never heard it, and again, kind of out of sight, out of mind, Paul Weller, do I like him, do I not like him, I'm not sure. Anyway, I was at my local record store. I went there to buy the new copy of Best Coast's new album. And I had enough cash on me to think, okay, well, I've got enough money for one more album. What do you want? So I look and I look and I look, and really nothing's catching my eye. It's just one of those days where it's like, the used bin didn't have anything good in it. I really didn't have anything in mind. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to take a chance. I'm going to pick up the new Paul Weller album. And boy, am I glad I did, because this is a fantastic, fantastic album. And I gotta tell you, Ben Simpson, you picked a great album for your best of 2015 so far, because it is really spectacular. And I just happened to get lucky, I guess. Maybe this is a standard edition. You guys will have to tell me if you know, but this happens to be on a nice red vinyl. And it does say limited. It said limited on the hype sticker. So I don't know how many were red versus how many were black, but my local record store had just one copy of this, and it was on red vinyl. And I didn't even realize it until I got home with it that it was red vinyl, because it said very small that it was red. But irregardless of that, this is a really, really fine album. So I thought, okay, we're on a roll here. Love that box set. I love this. And I thought, okay, one more thing before I bite the bullet here and start getting into some things I don't know anything about. I went and picked up this next. This is a compilation of Paul Weller's solo material from, I don't know, this is probably from like the mid to late 90s through today. This is a 2-LP set, and this covers, you know, like I said, all of his solo singles and whatnot. There's a new track on here that was unavailable prior to this release. And I really like that too, so I'm like, okay, Paul Weller, you know, you're really, I think I found something here. So that's what led me to think, okay, now it's time for me to get into some of the things that started his career. You know, he was a big staple in the early 80s, you know, in the UK music scene with The Jam, and I know nothing about The Jam. So I start looking online and I see that the record prices here and availability of Jam records are pretty slim. I've never seen it. I don't think I've ever seen a Jam record out in the wild. Now, of course, I wasn't looking really per se, but I know they're not very common. They really never had any big U.S. albums. I see here on Wikipedia, their highest chart success ever was number 72. Most of them were in the hundreds or 200 range. They didn't really have chart success. The Jam did not. But in the UK, they had a number 1 album, number 2 album, number 4 album, number 6 album, number 20 album. Very consistently good. So I would say that I was going to spend a great deal of money probably buying Jam records that were not easy to find and probably going to be paying quite a bit for them. So I looked online and I saw that they recently put out a box set. And that's what leads us to this moment when I'm going to show you and talk about the Jam box set. Now, I must admit, I have not heard a single album of this yet, but I looked on YouTube. I didn't see any talk about The Jam. I didn't see any videos on this box set, so I thought, well, maybe my viewers, maybe other people might be interested in seeing what this box is about and kind of seeing my progression and what led me to purchase it, even though I really never heard any of their records. So, without further ado, here it is. Here is The Jam box set. This is... it's actually 8 LPs. They have had only 6 studio albums, but as we get through the box, I'm going to show you what else you get with the box set. You can kind of see the albums, how they look there. Did come in shrink. It was brand new. And it is a very plain, simple design. You only get these arrows going all the way around. You can see that it follows along the bottom, and then the spine is just black. So it's black on black. Very thick cardboard, though, I must say. It's a well-made box. And I think, you know, as far as quality goes, Back to Black is the maker of this album, this box set. And I think from past experience, I've always been very pleased with Back to Black as far as the quality of their vinyl pressings. So I think I'll have to come back and make some comments, but I think the quality is going to be really good. So let's go through and I'll show you what you get. 1977 was their debut album. This is called In the City. All these albums, by the way, are on 180 gram, nice heavyweight vinyl, original artwork, non-gatefold. None of them are gatefold, but that's originally, it looks like, the way they were made. So it's pretty true and pretty accurate to the originals. I'm not going to show you all of the labels, but I'll show you a couple, I suppose. I should show you, actually, that it did come with a hype sticker. I kept the hype sticker from the original shrink wrap. It kind of tells you all that you get with it. And there is a lot. And then I just dropped it, but I'll show you that it, I'm not going to show you the number, but it does come with a download card. So you can download the entire box set onto your computer and your iPod or whatever you listen to. So here's the labels. They're all black vinyl. And I'm assuming that these are replicas of the original label as well. So anyway, nice heavyweight black vinyl. Debut album, In the City. Now, I am really, more than any other video, anxious for comments because you guys are going to know more about this band than I do. Ben Simpson, others, all my UK followers, anybody who likes this band, I really want to know what your favorite albums are, your favorite tracks, you know, how you think I did, if I made the wrong stupid decision and, you know, I shouldn't have bought the box. I don't know. Just leave me comments because I'm really anxious to hear your thoughts on this box. Okay, so that was 1977. And then I see they have a second album also from 1977, and it's called This is the Modern World. Sorry, it's a bit of a tongue twister. And I must say, none of their album covers are very stunning or, you know, not great artwork or anything, so I'm not overly impressed with the artwork or the photography or the design of their album covers. But it looks like maybe Arrows was a bit of a theme for the band. You know, someone's going to have to help me out and help me decide if that's accurate. It's on the cover of the box, and I see it here on Paul Weller's jumper, his sweatshirt as well. So, anyway, this also came out in 1977, it looks like. Yeah, 1977. So, I guess I may as well just show you the label again. Well, this is in a better sleeve, I suppose. It's a picture sleeve, so I'll pull it out real quick. But they are, again, very heavyweight vinyl. Very nicely done. And again, I will mention that Back to Black has very good reputation for high quality represses, so I'm assuming this is going to sound really good. So I'll have to leave some comments and get back to you on how the albums actually sound. Okay, you also get a copy of 1978's All Mod Cons. This album cover is a little bit better, very dated, of course, but you know, 1980, everyone kind of looked the same and whatnot, so had the same bit of stylistic look to it or whatnot. The haircuts and the clothing, it's a bit Miami Vice looking there. But anyway, you know, it's really not a bad album cover. And again, I apologize, I have never heard these records, so I'm just simply showing you the box. Here is the inner sleeve, you get the lyrics on one side, and you get the, I'm assuming, original artwork that came in the original LP on the other side. So, nice copy of All Mod Cons from 1978. And 1979, they did an album called Setting Suns. This might be the least attractive album cover of the bunch. I don't know, maybe it's the best in some people's opinions, but I certainly don't understand what it means. It looks like some photograph of a statue. Anyway, here's the back cover. Nothing too exciting there. Just a dog on the beach with the inverted British flag, it looks like. And then the inner sleeve is lyrics again on one side with that same dog. And then some picture of crap that looks like it rolled up on the beach. An old uniform of some sort. What I heard from the CD, though, I know it was only about 20 or 22 songs. The way I would describe the Jam, if you've never heard them, like me, is they're kind of punk rock, but I'm not a fan of punk rock music, but they have definitely more stylistic elements to them, definitely more melody, better lyrics, better song structure. It's not just bam, 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 punk rock. It's definitely got some structure to it, so that's what drew me to it, and the songs are actually really catchy, but mostly quick and kind of stylized like punk rock, but in a much more flavorful kind of way, I guess you could say. That's probably a really poor description of the Jam, but that was my early impressions. All right, from 1979 we go to 1980. We get an album called Sound Effects, and this one, you know, it's got more of a collage type album cover to it, and the back cover, not much to say about that other than it's just pretty darn plain. But again, a bit of a sign of the times, you know, 1980. Album covers generally weren't that dynamic or impressive, I guess, for the most part. I really like the inside picture so much more. You know, this would have been a much more attractive album cover, in my opinion. But nevertheless, here we have more lyrics and some photos of the band. So I cannot tell you my favorite tracks. I can't tell you what I think of each album, do any type of a ranking yet. It's just way too soon. So I'll have to come back and do another video or just continue to make comments on this one. And then finally you get a copy of 1982's The Gift, which appears to be their last studio album. This one came out in 1982, and I don't have any information on why the band broke up, what led them to their demise, but I'll show you something here in a minute that will help me get to know more about the band and another reason why I decided on the box set. So that is it on studio albums. They had 6 studio albums. The last one, this was their one and only UK number one album. The previous one, Sound Effects, that I just showed you, hit number 2. So as you can see, they're pretty popular in the UK. All right, but with the box set, and another 2 reasons why, 3 reasons I bought the box set. One I've already explained to you because the albums are hard to find here. Secondly, you get some extra material with it, and I'll show you what they are. You get two extra albums. You get B-sides called Extra Specials. This one is from 1977 to 1982. This is B-sides from singles. You can see how they've designed that. So that's Volume 1. And you also get Volume 2, Extra Special, 1977 to 1982. And more B-sides, so a lot of extra material on here, so that's cool. And another big draw for me to say, okay, what do I want to do? I want to collect studio albums, or do I want to bite the bullet and get the box set? And then finally, really one of the other reasons I decided on the box set is because it comes with this really, really nice hardbound book. There's the front cover, here's the back cover. It's not terribly thick, it's about 100 and so pages. Let's see here. I don't know if they're numbered. That doesn't look like they're numbered. But you get a long, long history of the band, all kinds of information, some great photographs. I'll do my best to show you without having to move the camera and edit and all that. But it's really well done. Some glossy, some not so glossy, but it's really the information I'm after. I want to know more about the band. I want to kind of hear about how they formed and what led to their success and, you know, what led to them breaking up. So hopefully there's a lot of that in here. So that was kind of the final straw for me and the reason why I decided to get the box set. So there you have it. There is the Jam box set 1977 through 1982. You get the download card. You get this really plain looking box, but inside a lot of great stuff and a lot of good albums. So I've got a lot of listening to do, as you can see. You know, so be careful what you buy, because you could buy a CD box set, very inexpensive, and it leads to all this stuff, but and it's really good. I'm always interested in finding new music, whether it's new to me or new, you know, 2015 or 2000s, and this is by no means new music, but it's certainly new to me. So I hope you've enjoyed looking with me at the Jam, the studio recordings on Back to Black. If you're interested, I paid about $150 plus $4 shipping from Amazon. I've seen it as high as $200 and something. There was one less priced one for $130, but it was used and it said it had a dent in it, and I'm like, oh, well, for $20, I'm just going to go ahead and get with a brand new one and shrink. Don't have to worry about anything. It's not worth taking a chance for $20 when you're getting something that's that much money. So I did pay a bit for it. Probably a bit more in the UK, but certainly their studio albums are much, much easier to find. They're probably very inexpensive, so it might be overkill for you guys there. But for me, I think I made the right choice. So please leave your comments, let me know what you think, and I can't wait to hear some opinions about the music and the band and what you like best, favorite songs, all that kind of stuff. So let's have it. Let's have it. Have fun with the comments, and we'll see you next time for a different video. Until then, take care of yourselves, and bye for now.